shower in all my life! You recruits are here for one reason only, and that reason is war! I said, war! Are you in love, Private? Then don't look at me or give me nightmares. Lights! Australasia, a collection of islands in the South Pacific. Reconnaissance has shown that these islands are rich in swill. Shut up! Swill is the lifeblood of pigs. Control the swill, and you control the world. And that means war. What does it mean?
War, Sergeant!
Precisely. And as soldiers, our job is to fight. Destroy. With guns and bombs and knives and with your bare hands. But before that avenue of pleasure, a series of training films to prepare you for every eventuality in the theater of warfare. Roll it!
Armies on the march. The world divided. The threat of attack from the land, the sea, and the air. No Sunday roast this week. While the soldiers are in the thick of it, back home there's plenty of work to go around. Like making high explosive bombs. Anti-tank bombs. And making other bombs. So let's make the most of it. That's the ticket. And remember, lads, a war is won at home and not just on the battlefield. There is no excuse for malingering. With any luck, it should all have blown over by Christmas.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to something a little bit different. Kind of. This is Let's Both Play Hogs of War. Yay. Hopefully the start of a new series that we're always going to be doing at least one game co-op. This game might need a little bit of introduction. Yeah, hey, look, I'm suffering here. I got a bit of a rancid cold.
What have you done? What have
just
I done?
Just go back.
I can't. How?
Just go to okay.
Done it.
There we go.
Right.
So this is essentially Worms 3D before Worms 3D.
But so much better. It's just,
a lot better.
I love this game. There's nothing... I can't say a bad word about it. Everything about it is amazing.
I can say a few bad words about it.
Like what?
Well,
we're
going to
play as Tommy's Trots, by the way.
Okay, we're going to play as Tommy's Trots.
I'm going to keep the name Tommy's Trots. What's so bad about it?
Well, there's nothing terrible about it. It just wasn't...
I could play this from now until the end of time and I would be a happy, happy lady.
I don't think you would.
I would be happy.
Now, this game is awesome. We played a lot of it.
So good.
Back during our college years.
I played it all throughout my childhood as well.
And childhood.
So much.
Isn't it funny though that even though we had like the original Xbox and the PS2 and GameCube and that lot, we always played this.
It's just
we
amazing. Played a lot of this. Amazing game. I think that one's the one that's modded on Ricky Gervais.
Ricky Gervais? Rick Mayo.
Rick Mayo.
Yeah, of course.
Oh, maybe that's not him, actually. I was thinking, that looks like Ricky Gervais a bit. Just a picture, a little bit. If he was a pig.
I guess it could do. I mean, why not?
Sorry.
So anyway, we're going to be playing as Tommy's Trotters. Nicky's playing the game. I'm just here for, I don't know.
Moral support.
Yay!
This is war right now, guys. Wah!
Wah! Okay.
Right, we're going to do the training. I wasn't good. What? Wait, what?
You're trying to promote your pigs. You got no promotion points.
I thought I was on start. I've got Ginger Nobby. Who is it?
Ponsonberry.
No, it's me.
I always called him Ponsonberry.
Well, from this day forward, he will be called Ponsonberry. Ponsonsmith? What?
Ponsonsmith.
I used to love it as well. I used to spend ages just going up and down. Because sometimes the pigs almost fall off the platforms.
They do stuff.
And I think they do stuff depending on their rank.
Really?
So look at him, he's checking himself. What's he going to do?
He's checking himself.
Oh my god!
Cough.
Oh. Hey, he's after
They're not being very entertaining.
Yeah, sorry. Yeah, we'll
play
do
the
training
mission. We're going to give it a go.
We wasn't going to, but then we thought
the dialogue is worth it. We've had a couple of issues recording this game. So we actually brought the game again, and it's working. But for some reason, when we finished this before...
Yeah, you'll see on our memory card there's actually a save.
Yeah.
Welcome to boot camp. Now, you may be as green as the grass now, but by the time you leave, you will be an efficient fighting machine.
You will.
Let's get to it.
Come on, then. Let's be coming up.
Find the green path around the corner and collect your first weaponry by walking into the crate. Notice a pickup is a little brown dot on your mini-map. Good. Now shoulders back.
I wonder, if you can destroy it.
I doubt it. There's no map.
I know, I'm just saying.
Oh, the wonders are coming back.
I know.
The wonders where anything's possible in a game.
Your skill menu out.
Your skill menu.
Press the X button to select your bayonet. Later on, you'll have more weapons to choose from. Now,
right, let's stick him. Stick him good.
Toe to toe with your enemy. Walk up to the target and stick it right into him.
What the? He's got two faces.
Wow.
Two faces.
You just can't sneak up on him.
I know.
It's a bit of an advantage,
really. I was doing a bit of Sam Fisher or whatever. Check that.
Bit of stealth action.
I'm really tempted to try and blow down that gate now.
You can try, but I don't think you actually can.
You know, like when you're a kid and you play a game so much that you just breeze through it and you don't actually notice things.
Mm-hmm.
And you go back and play it and you notice things. I've just noticed that. And I'm filled with wonder right now.
Get your rifle out. Well, why don't we wait until we get the rocket launcher?
Bazooka.
The bazooka. Ah, but you can't go back.
Oh, I don't know. Actually, I probably won't risk it.
You might have a few troubles.
To look through the sights, aim at the target, then press the X button to fire.
Hit
both targets, and we will move on.
Move on.
Move on.
You trying to shoot him in the dick?
Incoming.
You shouldn't shoot.
You should never shoot a guy in the dick.
No, you
although I can tell you right now, I will be shooting guys in the dick.
Charmed. Come on, careful.
Blaine, Donald Max.
What did he say?
I have no idea. That was some up country talk.
Some up country talk.
You know what they're like.
Yeah. Sniper rifle. Hey.
The basic principle of this weapon is exactly the same as the standard.
I do like the sniper rifle.
Automatically zoom in to save your poor little keeper. But the longer you stay zoomed, the more erratic your aiming gets. Shoot the two new targets at the double!
Alright, calm down, Rick, come on. IP Grimley, I believe his name is.
Yeah.
Geronimo!
Good shot. Hey.
Thank you, and that was a rather nice accent, if I do say so myself.
Pretty good, actually.
It was pretty good.
Yeah, not bad. Aye. But, you know, a little bit improved.
Enemy beware!
Right in the sack.
Now, I think you might be ready for something slightly more explosive.
Yeah.
Now you might.
Find the red path to the grenade range and collect your new equipment. You know the drill by now, you horrid little hog.
Horrid little
very nice.
I know he's a dick to us.
He's really hard on these pigs.
And there's a bit more to it than the weapons you've had your trotters on so far. So pay attention. Press and hold the X button to set the amount of power you want on the meter at the bottom of the screen. You can press the X button again to detonate the grenade. Remember, more power equals more distance. So what are you waiting for then?
Fire! Oh, shot!
Good shot! Full 30 damage on that,
grenade?
Model.
Oh.
I was going to say. Now you have to be careful with the physics in this game.
Hey?
The physics. You get a little
hairy.
Little dents in the land.
Round to the water range for a bit of secret training.
Secrets?
Ooh.
Quick march, I'm on my way, sir.
I like secret training.
Sir, yes, sir.
What are we going to learn in secret?
Right up the Aris.
That's what we're going to learn in secret.
Yeah. Makes sense.
Really? Is that what they do to all the soldiers?
So I hear.
Cough.
Now, grenades have a bit more to them than meets the eye.
Careful.
If you get one out, sit a flat angle using the R2 button and loads of power, and it will skip across water like a stone. Destroy those targets on the far side of the water. Oh, and try not to fall in. It'll be a while before you're hard enough to try that.
What's he mean by that, I wonder?
Yes. Hint. This is a right life.
Beautiful.
I don't know what accent that was.
I don't know.
There is going to be loads of that as well, just to warn you.
Oh, quality accents, given, yeah.
Yeah, giving you heads up.
Quality accents. Careful.
This'll whack him up.
I was going to say, I didn't even know what he said then myself.
Throwing action coming on.
Thank
there.
You. Yeah, thanks.
Now for a bit of exercise. Follow the purple path and climb over the gate.
Okay. I actually think it's quite clever the way this board is laid out.
It's cute.
With all the different colour paths and things. Oh, health.
I think I'm going to need that.
Now this could be tricky, so listen. You have
listen
to
up.
Cross the broken bridge over there, line yourself up with the bridge, and take a bit of a run up, press the square button to jump the gap, and try not to get any wetter than you already are.
Try.
Ready.
Go. He can do it.
Yeah.
Oh, that was actually worrying for a minute.
Because
he didn't jump.
Right, now, this is quite possibly the biggest challenge that I face.
Good. Learning to collect as much health as you can, eh? Well, you'll need it if you encounter one of these.
Ooh, crap! Oh.
Crap.
A skillful tactic is to
blow really?
Enemies into them. They rarely come out.
A skillful tactic is to step on the mines.
And avoid them. Now, follow the worn path.
I did say, do you think you should get some practice? Oh, no. Like riding a bike.
It's fine.
Yeah, we're right. A few scratches, a few dings here and there. Gonna have to significantly improve, though, I think.
This can cause serious grief, so be very careful with it, all right? We are going to demolish the door of this house.
Yeah.
Select your TNT and place the charge by pressing the X.
Demolish
button.
The door. Not the pig. The door.
And don't go back into the minefield.
No, and again.
Don't go back into the minefield.
Oh, you should see the testing video of this. I wish it didn't scroll.
Go! Go, pig!
Run!
Yeah! I didn't die.
Door squeaking,
eh? Certainly will stop the door squeaking. I wonder what could be in there. What goodies?
Like a boss. Taking your hair.
Yes, we put that here just in case you need a little top up. Now,
little top
head over to that shelter across the minefield for another useful nugget of info.
Straight now, careful
up,
here.
But be careful.
Careful. There'd have to be some bell end outside using a hammer, wouldn't there?
I know, dinging. They might be using a bell, you don't know.
A bell?
Bollocks!
Oh, really?
Fuck's sake.
I'll tell you what.
What?
Whenever you have to go through a minefield, I will take control of the controller. Is that okay?
No.
And then when I feel you're ready, we will take the training wheels off.
Sir Mayo is speaking.
All of the services, get close to it and press the triangle button to get in. They offer around 100 points of armor. Most
not bad.
Vehicles and machines are used in the same way. So press the triangle button again to get out.
Alright.
Here, collect your last bit of pith at the end of the purple bar.
No, you can't go back, actually.
No.
You could do it with grenades.
Now, this is your last piece of training. Use your bazooka to destroy...
I wouldn't trust you to go back through the minefield anyway.
Bazooka in the same way as the grenade. But it goes a lot further.
A lot further. Right, let's do this thing. Now, about half power for the first
easy,
one.
Easy, lemon squeeze.
And about 75%. Ooh, good shot. Yeah, good shot.
Shot.
Now, about half power, I reckon. Maybe because we did it earlier.
Bodies and blood and things blowing up. It's not a minute piece.
No. A minute piece.
Never. Ooh, look at that. Full damage.
His head.
Beautiful.
Yeah, get on, Ginger.
But what are you waiting for then? Off to war with you.
Yay, off to war. Now the game really begins. Now, hopefully, the recording's recorded.
Yes.
You might be able to hear the PlayStation as well. The Yeti's quite close to the PlayStation. It's just like...
And the PlayStation is rather loud.
It is, isn't it? It's not quite as loud as the Dreamcast.
No, true.
But it is loud. Right, okay, we're going to end the video there. We're not actually going to risk going to save team, because I think that might have been what glitched out last time.
That's
but I hope you enjoyed this video. We have. Yep. And we're going to enjoy the rest of the war.
Yeah.
So I hope to catch you next time. Thanks for watching, guys.
Cheers.